We got a problem.
There probably isn't another team in the NBA that has been more consistent in the last 5 years than the Toronto Raptors. This franchise has reached the playoffs for 7 straight years, winning around 66% of their games in that span. Head coach Nick Nurse did not just maintain the level of success when he took over, he actually elevated the team's success. In his first 2 years, he has a winning percentage of just over 70% and led the Raptors to their first NBA championship in franchise history. This is probably the deepest team in the league, and much like the Miami Heat, the Raptors have a knack for finding great prospects late in the draft and finding undrafted players who develop into impact players for this team. Ever since the Raptors had their first 50-win season 5 years ago, they have won at least 50 games in every season since. 5 straight seasons with at least 50 wins. The next closest is the Milwaukee Bucks with just 2 straight seasons. The Raptors have a great organization, and a lot of the credit can go to the coaching staff and the culture they have created, and you can't forget about Masai Ujiri and the front office. Most people expected at least some kind of a drop-off in the regular season without Kawhi Leonard, but the Raptors played just as good, if not better, in the regular season without Kawhi. But you knew when the playoffs started, a player like Kawhi is the kind of guy you need to get you over the top. The Raptors fell short of defending their championship last year as they lost in the second round to the Boston Celtics. Most of their success is built off their defense. They have ranked in the top 10 in opponents' points per game in the last 5 years. Last year, they was one of the best defensive teams in the league. And if they have any shot of making a deep run in the playoffs, their defense has to be top-notch. Losing big man Marc Gasol and Serge Ibaka is a big blow for not only the defense, but the overall team. Both players help the offense out with their ability to stretch the floor, and they were one of the 2 best defensive big men in the league. Even though Gasol's production has gone down in the last couple of years, he still had great chemistry with his teammates, and he's still one of the best passing big men in the league. The 2 players that will have to make up for the loss of those two are Aaron Baines and young stud Chris Boucher. Boucher played limited minutes for the Raptors last season, but when he played, he showed he had the talent and size to be a difference maker. Boucher is the first player in the G League to ever win both the league's Most Valuable Player and Defensive Player of the Year awards. He doesn't have the strength and muscle that Ibaka and Gasol have, but he's athletic and plays with 100% effort. Boucher will finally get guaranteed minutes every game to prove that he belongs. Baines was signed as a free agent this offseason, and he has become a reliable three-point shooter. After only taking 28 three-pointers in his first 6 seasons, he took 168 last season and shot 35%. That's less than what Gasol and Ibaka shot last year, but 35% from 3 from a center is exceptional. And he isn't as good on defense as those two are either, but he's above average. Even when Kawhi Leonard was on the team 2 seasons ago, Kyle Lowry was still the leader of the team. He and Fred VanVleet are the heart and soul of this team. You could say that Lowry had one of his best seasons of his career last year. His impact goes way beyond his stat line, but he did give you 19-7-5 while shooting 35% from 3. Earning him his 6th All-Star appearance. Lowry is the heartbeat of this team. There's nothing he loves more than to step in front of a player on defense and draw an offensive charge. Lowry seems to always end up on the floor in some way, form, or fashion, but that's something he doesn't mind doing. He loves scratching and clawing for loose balls. Anything he can do to get his team an extra possession, Lowry will do it. That's why his impact expands way beyond his stat line. And his backcourt teammate Fred VanVleet is almost built the same way. VanVleet absolutely had his best year of his short career last season. The main reason why Nick Nurse is able to start 2 undersized point guards in the backcourt is because both are excellent defensive players. Even though they are both around 6 feet tall, they are strong and physical, and they always seem to get deflections that leads to a takeaway. For a player that was undrafted and signed the kind of contract he did this offseason, it's pretty incredible. Fred VanVleet signed a 4-year, $85 million contract to remain with the team that gave him a chance to play in this league. That's an average of around $21 million a year. Not bad for an undersized point guard that was undrafted in 2016. Like I said earlier, this franchise has a good history of finding talent late in the draft, and they did it once again with their 29th overall pick this year. Not only is Malachi Flynn very talented, but he fits the mold of the two point guards already on the team. He plays hard, has a high basketball IQ, and can play defense. Flynn has already made his presence felt in the NBA preseason. Just like with Lowry and Van Vliet, he comes in with a lot of experience under his belt as he played 3 years in college. Flynn makes up for his size with his deep range on his jump shot and his instincts on both ends of the court. He has first team all rookie written all over him, and he could be the reason why the Raptors decide not to re-sign Kyle Lowry when he becomes a free agent in 2021. After Kawhi Leonard left, Pascal Siakam became the number one option for the first time in his career. In his fourth season, he became the sixth player in franchise history to be selected to an All-NBA team, joining Vince Carter, Chris Bosh, Kyle Lowry, DeMar DeRozan, and Kawhi Leonard. But as good as he was in the regular season, he had a very disappointing playoff performance and didn't step up as the best player on the team. That's one of the main reasons why the Raptors lost in the second round to the Boston Celtics. The organization has put a lot on his shoulders, and he has to bounce back from a subpar playoffs and be the player the Raptors believe he can be. OG Anunoby had one of the biggest shots in his short career in Game 3 against the Celtics in the second round. There was a good chance that the Raptors were on the verge of being swept out of the playoffs before OG hit that shot to win the game. He brings consistency as a good defender and a good three-point shooter, and he always seemed to be available. He played in 69 of the Raptors' 72 regular season games. OG had career highs across the board, and it seems he's getting better every game. He's another player that was drafted in the 20s as a lot of teams passed him up. The Raptors probably have the best chemistry of any team in the league. No matter which players comes in or which players leave, this team will find a way to maintain the same success throughout the regular season. I've always felt for a team to win a championship, you need at least a top 10 or a top 5 player on your team. There are always exceptions like the 2004 Detroit Pistons, but teams like that are very rare. Pascal Siakam is a good player and can get better, but I don't believe he can be the best player on the championship team. This team will still be one of the best teams in the Eastern Conference once again, but I don't believe they have a great chance of actually winning a championship with Siakam as their best player. He's better suited as the second best player. I have the Raptors finishing with the third seed with a record of 47-25. Their streak of 50 plus win seasons will end, but that's mostly because it's a 72 game season. This team will go out and beat a lot of teams in the regular season. But I believe their margin for error is very small when you don't have a top 10 or top 5 player on the team. I believe the second round in the playoffs is the best case scenario for this team, just like last season.